فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Sorry, Mazal al-Sirsawi's kitab, which the taqdeem of Ahmed Ma'bad Abdul-Karim and Ishaq al-Huwayni put on for him, is not the al-Du'afa by Abu Nu'aym Abdul-Malik ibn Muhammad ibn Adi al-Jurjari. Rather, it's this one, and it's al-Kamil fi Du'afa al-Rijal. It's the ninth book, sorry. It's by Abi Ahmed Abdullah ibn Adi ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Mubarak al-Jurjari. Rahimahullah ta'ala. It's very well known as Ibn Qattan. Ibn Adi's kitab is the one I personally suffice myself when it comes to the concept of Du'afa al-Rijal. I really don't go beyond that. Because what he did was, he basically took all of the people who were criticized. Even if those people who were criticized are in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. Whether that criticism is justified and it's right, or whether that criticism is incorrect, he doesn't look at it. Like, who criticized the hadith, the riwayat in Bukhari and Muslim? Like al Imam Ad-Darqutni mathalan, Abu Mas'ud al-Dimashqi mathalan, Abu Ali al-Jayyani rahimahullah ta'ala and others, they criticized the riwayat in Sahihain. So what he does is Ibn Adi rahimahullah ta'ala in his Kamil, he brings all of those narrators in that book of his, and it's the most complete book I personally believe when it comes to the du'afa in the men that are criticized. ولذلك الكتاني who has a kitab called الرسالة المستطرفة, he says وهو أكمل كتب الجرح وعليه الاعتماد وعليه الاعتماد فيها. He says it's the most complete book of جرح والتعديل, or الجرح specifically. وإلى ما يقوم رجح المتقدمون والمتأخرون. This is the book that the mutaqaddimun and the mutaakhirun, those who came early and those who came after, they really just stood over this kitab of his, really. And they didn't move on from his works. So his kitab, because it has all of the narrators who were criticized, and his book is more than 11 volumes, or even 11 or 12, 13 something volumes. It's big, it's very big. And also, he also even goes to the narrators who are criticized in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. Number 10 is Al-Du'afa by Abi al-Fath, Muhammad ibn al-Husayn ibn Ahmed ibn al-Husayn al-Azdi. He died in the year 374. Dhahabi said about him in his kitab Tadhkiratul Hufad, لَهُمْ مُصَنَّفُ الْكَبِيرُ فِي الضُعَفَاءُ وَهُوَ قَوِيُّ النَّفْسِ فِي الْجَرْحِ. And he's a person who's strong in his criticism. Another person is Kitab al-Du'afa wal-Matrukin, which is the 11th book, and it's written by Abil Hassan Ali ibn Umar al-Darqutni, who died in 385. And again, it's with the tahqiq of Subhi al-Samarra'i, and also the tahqiq of Dr. Sabbagh. And Al-Maktabat al-Islami, they're the ones who published it when it was the year 1980 Miladi, the Gregorian calendar. You also have the Kitab al-Du'afa by Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani, who died in 430. You have the Du'afa also, number 13, written by Khatib al-Baghdadi, Ahmed ibn Ali ibn Thabit, who died in 463 Hijriya. You also have the 14th one, which is al-Du'afa, written by Abi al-Faraj AbdulRahman ibn Ali, who's really well known as Ibn al-Jawzi, who died in 597 Hijriya. There's a Kitab al-Du'afa. You also have the Kitab al-Mughni fi al-Du'afa. Al-Mughni fi al-Du'afa. And this Kitab al-Mughni fi al-Du'afa is written by Abi Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ahmed ibn Uthman al-Dhahabi, who died in 748 Hijriya. And the tahqiq is done by none other than Nuruddin al-Itr. Nuruddin al-Itr, afallahu anhu. May Allah forgive him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 16, Mizan al-I'tidal fi naqd al-Rijal by Dhahabi, rahimahullahu ta'ala. And the tahqiq is done by Muhammad Ali Al-Bajawiyu, rahimahullahu ta'ala. Number 17 is Diwan al-Du'afa by Dhahabi. And it's done with the tahqiq of the Allama, al-Shaykh Hamad al-Ansari. You also have 18, which is Zaylul Mizan, which is by Zainuddin AbdulRahman ibn al-Husayn al-Iraqi, which he added on to the Mizan al-I'tidal written by Dahabi. And the tahqiq again is Subhi al-Sumurra'i. Number 19 is Lisan al-Mizan. Lisan al-Mizan is basically Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, his criticism of the book Mizan al-I'tidal by Dahabi. And he called it Lisan al-Mizan. And it's written by Ahmad ibn Ali ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, who died the year 852 Hijriah. Last but not least, you have the Kitab al-Lum'a fi Asma'i man wada', written by Abi Bakr Abdurrahman ibn Muhammad ibn Umar Jalaluddin al-Suyuti, who died the year 911 Hijriah. So here we spoke about the books that are written in al-Du'afa, those who are criticized. And they're more than that. But this is ala sabili tamthil ila al-hasr. It's just some of the books that are out there. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to mention the books that are written in al-Thiqat, the reliable ones, those who are praised. ولذلك أكرم ضياء العمري هي كتاب كل بحوث في تاريخ السنة المشرفة. He says وقد صنف في الضعفاء حتى نهاية القرن الخامس الهجري 20 مصنفا. 20 books have been written in ضعفاء until the 5th هجري, the 5th century. 20 books alone were written on it. So 5 centuries. Yeah, 5 centuries into Islam. 5 qarn. Or the 5th century. What was written? 20 books written in what? Al-Du'afa. Within those 5 qarn, the books that were written in the Thiqat were how many? Only 4. So only 4 books were written in Thiqat, and the Du'afa are 20. Akram al-Diyar al-Umari mentions that. What does that show you? What does that bring to your attention? That they more focused on the criticism and to get rid of those who are infiltrating and trying to make up narrations against the Prophet ﷺ and lie about the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. So the books that have been written in Thiqat are less in number than what was written in another in the Du'afa. The Du'afa people spread too much into it. And the scholars الثقات والمتثبتين, written by Ali ibn Abdullah al-Madini, who died in the year 234 Hijriyah. He has a kitab called الثقات والمتثبتين. And the existence of this book is mentioned by Hakim al-Nisaburi in his kitab معرفة علوم الحديث. When he mentions the book, when he's mentioning the books of Ali ibn al-Madini, he mentions these books. He says, وَلَهُ كِتَابُ الثِّقَاتِ وَالْمُتَثَبِّتِينَ عَشَرَةَ أَجْزَاءِ. The second book is الثِّقَات, written by Abil Hassan Ahmad ibn Abdullah ibn Salih al-Ijli, who died in the year 261 Hijriah. This kitab by al-Ijli, rahimahullah, it was organized by Ibn Hajar al-Haythami bithla. Okay, he organized it in alphabetical order. And who did he start with though? He started with anyone whose name is Ahmed, because that's the Prophet's name. So he not to put any name before what? The name of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So he started with Ahmed. And this book is what? Is still makhtut. It's still makhtut, meaning it's still not published. If you want, I saw some of the makhtutat. They are present in Jami' Islamiyah, University of Medina. They have a section where you can go and you can see it. Number 3 is al-Thiqat, written by Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Hibban al-Busti, who died in 354. Saqawi says in his kitab al-I'lan bil-Tawbikh liman damma al-Tarikh, he says, huwa ahfaluha. This book is the most in gathering the Kitab of Ibn Hibban al-Busti. It's the most ahfal, meaning it's the most, it gathered the most. وهو على طبقات, and he writ it according to levels. And Haythami worked on it as well. He worked on it and he organized it alphabetically. The way that this book is written is as follows. Because this is the best book that's been said about by Sakhawi. How is it written? It's written in the following. He starts with those people whose criticism is not known. So he starts by mentioning those whose criticism is unknown to him. So he puts forward those people who he doesn't know any criticism regarding them. Even if this person is unknown. And it's very important that the person does that and realizes that. Because if you open the kitab by Al-Thiqat ibn Hibban and then you just say, oh, he's thiqa, where did you get it from? Ibn Hibban said it. And you got it from the first part of where he transmitted it from. The first narrators that he's bringing forward are who? People who he does not know any jarh regarding them. Even when in kana majhoolan, even if it's this person is unknown. No one knows his situation. So this is very, very important that a person is alert with this and he understands this. And that, the scholars, they mention that Ibn Hibban, the people in which he mentions in this kitab of his Al-Thiqat, that he brings in this book, and he just merely mentions them. He doesn't speak about them, he just merely mentions their name in the book. The scholars, they say this is from the what? Min adna darajat al-thiqat. About al-tawthiq. That this person is from the lowest rated level of tawthiq. I mean, you still haven't brought a strong proof to show that this person is what? That he's thiqa. And this book was published in Matba'at al-Da'irat al-Ma'arif al-Uthmaniyya. In Haydarabad in Deccan, in India. And the person who used to sit there is who? AbdulRahman Yahya al-Mu'allimi used to be in India. He used to be sitting there. AbdulRahman Yahya al-Mu'allimi was sitting there in this Maktabatu Da'irat al-Ma'arif al-Uthmaniyya in Haydarabad in Deccan. He used to sit there. AbdulRahman Yahya al-Mu'allimi was from he was from Yemen. He sat there and he used to work on those books. They said he was married to a very old Indian woman. She didn't used to trouble him. She allowed him to seek knowledge, to attain knowledge, to write his works, to put his stuff together. That's what he used to do. So he lived there, rahimahullah ta'ala, for a very long time. He used to publish the books, he used to bring them out, and he worked on many of the books. Many of the books. Number four, Mashahir Ulama al-Amsar. Ibn Hibban al-Busti rahimahullah ta'ala wrote it. He died the year, again I mentioned, is 354. It's called Mashahir Ulama al-Amsari. And what he did here, Ibn Hibban, is he only mentions the famous, well-known, reliable individuals. So he mentions only the Mashahir. Mashahir means what? Famous. And he mentions them in levels. And then once he finishes mentioning them in levels, he goes towards mentioning them according to provinces and regions. So he starts methodically with the Sahabas from the people of Medina, and then he goes towards the Sahabas from Mecca, for instance, and he mentions it in that manner. Until he finishes all of the levels of the tabi'een, sahabas, then he starts mentioning the tabi'een, and then he mentions the atba'u tabi'een, and he mentions that in the order. And he mentions the tabi'een again in what region they're from. What region they're from. That's what he did. Number five is Tariq Asma'i Thiqat Mimman Nuqila Anhum Al-Ilm. And this kitab is written by Umar ibn Ahmad ibn Shaheen, who died in 375 Hijriya. Number six is Al-Madkhalu ila Sahihayni li Abi Abdillahi Muhammad ibn Abdillahi al-Hakim al-Naysaburi, who died the year 405 Hijriya. And if you go to this kitab Al-Madkhalu ila Sahihayni, there is in it the Tarajimu, the biography of Rijal al-Sahihayn, the men of Bukhari and Muslim. Number seven is Shams Muhammad ibn Aybak al-Saruji, who died in 744 Hijriya. He also wrote a book on Al-Thiqat. He didn't complete it. And if he was to finish it, they said it would have been more than 20 volumes. And if you look at the names that he has brought regarding Ahmeds, okay, he mentions one whole volume on it. It's a whole volume. Number 8. ذِكْرُ أَسْمَاءِ مَنْ تُكُلِّمَ فِيهِ وَهُوَ مُوَثَّقٌ. This is written by a Shaykh, Al-Imam Shamsuddin Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Uthman al-Dhahabi, who died in the year 748 Hijriyah. In this book, Dhahabi talks about people who've been spoken against, they've been criticized, but they're really reliable people. This shows you, what does this show you? That criticism is not قال الله قال الرسول. That when your Shaykh criticizes somebody, it doesn't mean that's it. They're clear now, the matter is clear. It doesn't necessarily mean that. Does it? Why would Dahabi write a book called ذِكْرُ أَسْمَاءِ مَنْ تُكُلِّ مَا فِيهِ. He mentions names of people being criticized. وَهُوَ مُوَثَّقٌ. But this person is what? It's praiseworthy. And this kitab, the tahqiq, is done by Muhammad Shakur Amrir. And in the Muqaddimah, he says something very powerful, which I'm going to read on you. He says, هَذَا فَصْلٌ نَافِعٌ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ ثِقَاتِ الرُّوَاتِ الَّذِينَ تَكَلَّمَ فِيهِمْ بَعْضُ الْأَئِمَّةِ بِمَا لَا يَرُدُّ أَخْبَارَهُمْ وَفِيهِمْ بَعْضُ الْلَيِّنِ وَغَيْرُ أَتْقَنُ مِنْهُمْ وَأَحْفَظُ فَهَؤُلَاءِ حَدِيثٌ إِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِي أَعْلَى مَرَاتِبِ الصَّحِيحِ فَلَا يَنْزِلُ عَنْ مَرْتَبَةِ الْحُسْنِ اللَّهُمَّ إِلَّا أَنْ يَكُونَ لِلرَّجُلِ مِنْهُمْ أَحَادِيثٌ تُسْتَنْكَرُ عَلَيْهِ وَهِيَ الَّتِي تُكُلِّمَ فِيهِ مِنْ أَجْلِهَا فَيَنْبَغِي التَّوَقُّفُ فِي هَذِهِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. He says فَصْلٌ. He says he mentions هَذَا فَصْلٌ نَافِعٌ. He says this is a very beneficial point or a very beneficial section, which is فِي مَعْرِفَةِ الثِّقَاتِ, in knowing people who are reliable, whose integrity is up there. الَّذِينَ تَكَلَّمَ فِي بَعْضُ الْأَئِمَّةِ. But some of the scholars have criticized them. بِمَا لَا يَرُدُّ أَخْبَارَهُمْ. Which does not reject their narrations. وَفِي بَعْضُ الْلَيِّنِ. And there are some who are layin, soft. وَغَيْرُهُمْ أَتْقَلُ مِنْهُمْ. And others are more stronger than them. وَأَحْفَظُ. And more greater in them. فَهَؤُلَاءِ حَدِيثُمْ إِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ. And he mentions some matters pertaining to that. But the point is that he wants to speak about in this book of his, and wants to bring to the attention of the people who've been criticized, but really they're really reliable. Number 9 is tartibu kitab al-thiqat li ibn Hibban ala huruf al-mu'jami. This is again written by Nuruddin Ali ibn Abi Bakr al-Haythami. I already spoke about it, which is when he basically takes the kitab of Ibn Hibban, he organizes it and he places it in a alphabetical order. And the person who requested from Haythami to do this was none other than his Shaykh Zainuddin al-Iraqi, and the son of Zainuddin al-Iraqi, who was Abi Zur'ata al-Iraqi. Iraqi has a son called Abi Zur'ah, and the father Zainuddin al-Iraqi, they requested from Al-Haythami to do this. Number 10 is Kitab al-Thiqat, Mimman Laysa fi al-Tahdhibi. This is number 10, which is people who are reliable, but you won't find them in the Kitab of Tahdhib. And it's written by Li Ahmad ibn Ali ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. Sakhawi said in his kitab Al-I'lan bi at-tawbikh liman dhamma at-tariikh wa afrada shaykhuna ibn Hajar al-thiqat mimman laysa fi at-tahdhib wa ma kamula. But he didn't finish it. Another kitab is written by Zainuddin ibn Qasim ibn Qutulubgha. It's written by Qutulubgha. This kitab is Kitab al-Thiqat. ولذلك الإمام الكتاني in his رسالة المستطرفة, he mentions that it's a kitab كبير في أربع مجلدات. It's a big book in its 4 volumes. I have never seen it. So those are the 11 books that we will mention inshallah ta'ala. And we're going to conclude by now mentioning inshallah ta'ala the books that are both. So they are both thiqat, and then you find in it al-du'afa. The amount that we're going to mention inshallah ta'ala are 19 books inshallah ta'ala that are all written in the field or written regarding al-thiqat wa al-du'afa, both. And the first one is At-Tabaqat Al-Kubra, written by Muhammad ibn Sa'ad ibn Mani' Al-Hashimiyu, who died in the year 230 Hijriya. What he did was he gathered all the levels of the Sahabas and the Tabi'een and those who came after them until his time. And to be honest, Ajada wa Afad wa Ahsana, he really has written it fairly and greatly. And his book is in 8 volumes. It's written in 8 volumes. There are 2 volumes that are in it that are the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and 6 are the tabaqat and the level. The tabaqat of Ibn Sa'd rahimahullah ta'ala. And this book was brought out into the Muslim world by an Orientalist, a German Orientalist, with the work and the help and the support of Muhammad Abdu Misri. They both worked together and they finished it when the year was 1918. Number two, is At-Tariq wal-Ilan by Yahya ibn Ma'in. And it's from the riwayah of Abil Fadl al-Abbas ibn Muhammad al-Duri, rahimahullah ta'ala, who is a student of Yahya ibn Ma'in. And this book is a compilation of the statements of Yahya ibn Ma'in in jarhu of men and the criticism of men, and knowing their lineage and their levels and etc. Number three is Ma'rifatul Rijal, written by Yahya ibn Ma'in. And this kitab, like the one before it, is a compilation of the statements of Yahya ibn Ma'in in the criticism and the praise of men. And the riwayah for the one Ma'rifatul Rijal is min riwayat Abil Abbas Ahmad ibn Muhammad ibn Qasim ibn Mahrizin al-Baghdadi an ibn Ma'in. Number four, we have Al-Ilal wa Ma'rifatul Rijal, written by Abi Abdullah Ahmad ibn Muhammad ibn Hanbal. And this kitab is the riwayah of Abdullah, the son of Ahmad ibn Hanbal. And the first volume was published, and recently the remaining was also brought out by none other than Al-Allama, Al-Doktor, Al-Sheikh, Wasiullah Abbas. Number 5 is At-Tariq al-Kabir, written by Al-Imam Abi Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ismail al-Bukhari, who died the year 256 Hijriya. And this kitab, again, it is published in the Taba' of Dar al-Ma'arif al-Uthmaniyya in India when the year was 1362. And it consists of 12,315 tarjama biographies in that book. All of it is organized in alphabetical order. And then again, it starts with the Muhammad's, because of the honor of the Prophet's name. And again, these are the works and the efforts of AbdulRahman Yahya al-Mu'allimi. These are the things that he was doing when he was in India. Number 6, Tariq al-Awsat, that is written by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala. And this Tariq al-Awsat is organized according to the years. Then you have a Tariq al-Saghir by Bukhari rahimahullah, which is matbu' mutadawal, and is published in India. Number eight, At-Tariq al-Kabir, written by Ahmad ibn Abi Khaythamah Zuhair ibn Harb, who died the year 279, he died. And Imam al-Hafidh Abu Bakr Ahmad ibn Abi Khaythamah Zuhair ibn Harb al-Nasa'i thumma al-Baghdadi, he's a great imam. He heard from Imam Ahmad, and the people who narrated from him are Baghawi, Ibn Sa'id, and other than him, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Bukhari also narrated from him. And Abu Dawood, they narrated from him. ولذلك الذهبي said about his kitab صاحب التاريخ الكبير, خطيب البغدادي said لا أعرف أغرز فوائد من تاريخي. Khatib al-Baghdadi said, I don't know anyone greater than him, more beneficial than his Tariq al-Kabir. Sakhawi said, Al-Kutub al-Mushtamila ala al-Thiqat al-Du'afai jami'an ka kitab ibn Abi Khaythamata wa huwa kathir al-Fawait. Sakhawi said, a book that consists of the reliable people and the criticized people, all of them together, like the book of Ibn Abi Khaythama, and it's full of benefits. Al-Kattani said in his Risalat al-Mustadrafa, he said, هو كبير أحسن فيه وأجاد في 30 مجلدا صغارا واثني عشرة كبارا ذكر فيه الثقات والضعفاء. It's a big book, 30 volumes. And he mentions the reliable people, and he also mentions the criticized people. You also have the ninth book, which is At-Tarikh, written by Abu Zur'ata AbdulRahman ibn Amr al-Nasari al-Dimishqi, who died the year 281 Hijriya. And it's written in 10 volumes. And it's Abu Zur'ata al-Dimishqi, who you all know. Rahimahullah. He died the year 281 Hijriya. Number 10 is Al-Jarh wa Ta'deel, written by who? Abi Muhammad AbdulRahman ibn Abi Hatim al-Razi. Abu Hatim al-Razi's son, AbdulRahman, he wrote it. He died the year 327 Hijriya. And this kitab is the best book written in Jarh wa Ta'deel. And the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, he organized it in alphabetical order. And the only part that he looks at when it comes alphabetically is again the name of the narrator and the name of his father. He places the companions first in all of the writings. He puts them first, rahimahullah ta'ala. And again, this book has been worked on by none other than in the publication house, Da'iratul Ma'arif al-Uthmaniyah in Hyderabad, Deccan, in India. And the person who worked it again is AbdulRahman Yahya al-Mu'allimi, and he has made for it a muqaddima that a person of knowledge should try to read. And if Allah gives us time, we will go through it. The muqaddima of AbdulRahman Yahya al-Mu'allimi, rahimahullah ta'ala. Number 11, Al-Mu'jam al-Mushtamilu ala dhikri asma'i shuyukh al-a'immat al-nubal. And this kitab is written by Abu al-Qasim ibn Asakir, rahimahullah, the great scholar. Abu al-Qasim al-Hassan ibn Ali ibn Hassan ibn Hibatullah al-Dimashqi. He's the author of the Tariq al-Dimashq, and he's an imam in hadith of his time. He was born 499 Hijriya and he died 571 Hijriya. If you want to see more about his biography, you can look at Shudurat al-Dhahab. But the thing with him is that his kitab, he only restricted himself to the shuyukh of Ashabul Kutub al-Sittah, six books of hadith. Duna riwayat al-akharina, he did not go into any other narrators. And he organized it in alphabetical order. Then you come to the kitab Al-Kamil fi Asma'ir Rijal. Al-Kamil fi Asma'ir Rijal. If you haven't been listening to all the other books that I mentioned, then this is important to start from here, because this is what 60% of our efforts goes towards these works. We rarely go to the other books ourselves. The kitab is Al-Kamil fi Asma'ir Rijal, written by Abi Muhammad Abdul Ghani ibn Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi al-Jamma'ili rahimahullah ta'ala. And this kitab is basically the narrators of the six books of hadith: Bukhari, Muslim, Abi Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, and Nasa'i. Okay? We're not going to now go into why did they only restrict these six books of hadith, and how did these restriction of these six books of hadith come? Why not Muwatta Imam Malik? Why is it not in the list? Why is not Musnad al-Tayalisi not in the list? Why is Musnad Sunan al-Darimi, why is it not in the list? Huh? And how was these six chosen from the rest? And who came up with the restriction of these six? That's another discussion, inshallah ta'ala. Ala kulli hal, the six books here we mean, the four Sunan, Sunan Abi Dawud, Sunan Ibn Majah, Sunan Abi Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i. And the two books, Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. Those six books, the narrators that are in those six books, any narrator in any of those six books, whoever they may be, the sheikh of the sheikh, it doesn't matter, you will find them in the kitab Al-Kamil fi Asma'i al-Rijal, written by Abi Muhammad Abdul Ghani ibn Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi, who died in the year 600 Hijriya. He mentions it in that book. But the beauty about Abdul Ghani's action than the action of Ibn Asakir is that Abdul Ghani, he even spoke about the Sahabas and the Tabi'een and the Tabi'een. He basically went through the whole chain of all of the six books of Hadith, every narrator in there, his life, his name, if he's reliable, if he's been criticized, what has he been criticized for? You go there. That same book was then what was being summarized. The speeches were too much, the volumes were too much, students' aspirations were starting to die out. So then Abu al-Hajjaj, Jamaluddin Abu al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Mizzi came, who died the year 742. What he did was he summarized the Kitab al-Kamal fi Asma'i al-Rijal, written by Abdul Ghani Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi. And what did he do? He summarized it. But this, when we say summarized, we don't mean that he got rid of vital information that were in there. He actually, someplace, had to even add it onto it. He's actually got points that he's got more information than the Kamal of Abdul Ghani. So to call it a summarization or a bridge is questionable. It's really questionable. Because what it really is it actually completed the points that were missing from Abdul Ghani, Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi. And any deficiencies that were in his works, he worked on it. And the best taba'a is, or tahqiq, is a tahqiq done by Dr. Bashar Awad Ma'roof, which he did on the Mu'assasat al-Risala. I have it. He did it twice. One is small amount, and the other time he spread it out. I think he reached it to 20 volumes, and once he reached it up to 6 or 7 volumes. Because the 6 and 7 volumes are big. But the 20 is actually smaller. Ala kulli hal, his one is the best, Bashar Awad Ma'ruf. But you also have to be careful. Bashar Awad Ma'ruf has got a very filthy aqidah. So his tahqiqat are good in books, in the way he does tahqiq, but his ta'liqat, his commentaries on statements, you have to look out for them. And some tahqiqat I saw, comments that he puts on, some masail pertaining to the Quran being created, he can no yamiru ilayha, and he's kind of affirming it. A'udhu billah. Number four, and if you see him, he's a man who has no beard. He wears a monkey suit, huh? A tie and stuff like that. And he works on these books. He worked on many books. 14, which is the Tahdhib al-Tahdhib. So it's Tahdhib al-Tahdhib. This is by who? It's Tadhib al-Tahdhib first. It's called Tadhib al-Tahdhib. And this is written by Shamsuddin Muhammad ibn Ahmad al-Dahabi rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam al-Dahabi rahimahullah ta'ala. And it's called Tadhib. And he died the year 748. What he did was he summarized the book of his own sheikh. Dahabi's teacher is Al-Hajjaj Mizzi, is the teacher of who? Dahabi. Is his teacher. So he summarized his teacher's works. All this that we're going to be mentioning are the summaries of the books. Number 15 is Al-Kashifu. The Kashif is a summary of the Kitab Tahdhib al-Kamal lil-Mizzi, rahimahullah ta'ala. So Dahabi has done two summarizations of the Kitab Tahdhib al-Kamal by Al-Imam Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi. Number 16, you have the Kitab Tahdhib al-Tahdhib, which is a summary of the Kitab of Al-Imam al-Mizzi. Okay? And this is done by who? Ahmad ibn Ali ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, who died in the year 852. He called it Tahdhib al-Tahdhib. He summarizes the Tahdhib al-Kamal fi Asma' al-Rijal, written by Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi. And he's not. He's summarizing Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi's kitab. Pay attention. And it is published by Taba'at al-Da'irat al-Ma'arif al-Uthmaniyah in India. AbdulRahman Yahya al-Mu'allim and others worked on it. Number 17 is Taqrib al-Tahdhib. Taqrib al-Tahdhib by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, which is a summary of the summary of his of Tahdhib al-Tahdhib of Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi. So he's summarizing his own Tahdhib al-Tahdhib. He summarized his own Tahdhib al-Tahdhib. He called it Taqrib al-Tahdhib. It's very small, it's one volume. You find it. And it's matbu' and it's mutadawal. 18, you have Ta'jeel al-Manfa'ah bi zawaid rijal al-A'immah al-Arba'ah. This is, on the other hand, Ibn Hajar rahimahullah ta'ala. Ibn Hajar here mentions, in this kitab, Ta'jeel al-Manfa'a, he mentions the rijal, the men, whose four madhabs are followed. The four a'immatul madhab that are followed, the books that they have written in hadith that are very well known. It's called Ta'jeel al-Manfa'a. Number 19 is called Khulasatu Tahdhibi. Sorry, Khulasatu Tahdhibi Tahdhib. Al-Kamal li Safiyya Deen Ahmed ibn Abdullah al-Khazraji, who died in 923 Hijriya. And it's a summary of the kitab written by Dhahabi, the Tahdhibu Dhahabi, Tahdhibu Tahdhib of Dhahabi. He summarized that one. And now what does that show you? That these scholars, the efforts and the hard work that the muhaddithin put in defending the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ from anyone lying about it, and they made principles and foundations and qawa'id that a person can study and learn in order to study the matter in more depth. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يوفقنا لخدمة دينه, that he gives us the ability to serve his religion and to spread the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives us sincerity and ikhlas, and that he accepts our righteous deeds. Allah is the one who is able to do that. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.